Well, if I'm asked the question, what's the best grip for me? I have to go back to history to give you the answer. Well, the history of putting started out with players just taking the normal grip. They would use the grip that they took for their full swings. And of course, in those times, the stroke would have been a little wristier because the greens really didn't have that much pace on them. So the players used a little bit more wrist to hit the ball with a little bit more power. And then players started to notice that excessive wrist action started to cause inconsistency and even the yips. So what happened then became the professional's grip, where the forefinger extended down over the fingers of the right hand, either all four fingers or three fingers. And the reason for that was to help keep the left wrist leading the stroke more. Also, green technology improved. Grasses were finer, greens were cut shorter, the ball traveled faster across them. So what would happen is that players didn't have to use any wrist action, certainly not voluntary wrist action. Well, then things progressed and players started to think, okay, if I'm going to really keep the left wrist out the stroke, let's go cross-handed. By keeping the left hand below the right, it helped keep the wrist action out of the stroke. Well, since then, things have moved on. Players are taking the claw grip, like so, and a variation on that, the saw, like so. But both these grips still to keep the left wrist leading, the left arm leading, the right hand pushing, and no involuntary wrist action. And even the players that take and secure with the belly putters or the chest putters to a point on their body and then swing the putter with just their right hand, they're pretty much doing the same thing. They're simply trying to eliminate involuntary wrist action. So when you ask me what's the best grip, I have to look at your stroke and decide how much wrist action do you use? That's the key question, because with that in mind, we can determine what's the best grip for you. If you're already very wristy, then a grip that helps really firm up the left wrist. But if you're rigid, you might want to go back in time to a grip that allows you to swing the putt with a little bit more freedom in the wrist. Whatever you choose, you still have to make a smooth stroke.